everyone. Welcome back to Quack. Today, Charlotte and I are going to talk to you about everything you need to know about the Indian runner duck. Let's get into it. All right, so let's talk about the history first. Indian runner ducks have been known to exist for about 200 years, although there are Javan temples that have etchings that depict the distinct body shape of the runner duck that was dated to almost 2,000 years ago. So runner ducks could have existed all the way up to 2,000 years ago. They were originally from the Indonesian islands and they came to Europe in the early 1800s. Duck herding was very common in the region and there were ducks roaming all over the island. Some of the first locations runner ducks were located was in India and Bali. It was not unusual for duck herders to have a flock of 1,000 or more Indian runners. When they would go to the market, the farmer would herd them and they would forage for food along the way. And because of this, only the strongest runner ducks would survive the journey, because sometimes the journeys would take up to 6 months to get to the market. So only the strongest of the ducks in the flock would survive. And it's thought that that's how they were bred to be such hardy ducks to begin with, because only the strongest ones would make it to the market. All right, let's talk about the physical attributes of the Indian runner duck. So they stand very upright, almost like a penguin, and their bodies are cylindrical in shape. Their skulls are wedge-shaped, and their bills are straight with their eyes set high on their head. They also have more compact tails than other domestic breeds. They stand between 20 and 26 inches from tail to crown. Mature drakes weigh between 3.5 to 5 pounds, and mature females weigh between 3 and 4 pounds. And they have more color variety than any other domestic duck. All right, let's quickly touch on the meat production aspect of runner ducks. So runner ducks are known as a light class breed. Their fat to bone ratio is high and their meat is said to be of the same quality as wild duck. They also have very little fat and their one runner duck could feed about 2 people. All right, now let's talk about egg production. So runner ducks will give you about 300 to 350 eggs per year. And their egg color comes in shades of white and blue. The hens do lay jumbo-sized eggs that weigh between 2.8 and 3 ounces, and they will lay consistently for about 4 to 5 years before the quantity, but not the quality, of the eggs decreases. Also, the hens rarely go broody, so if you want some baby runner ducklings, I would highly suggest investing in an incubator to do that, because they likely will not sit on the eggs for you. All right, and then lastly, we'll talk about the husbandry aspect of these ducks, since they were originally for herding and for farming. So they prefer to free range away from the house. So if you have Indian runner ducks, you can keep them in a run, but they would definitely prefer to have a large piece of property where they can free range pretty much all day. They have no special dietary or living needs. However, they do prefer to have a swimming area, because despite their awkward body shape, they are very graceful swimmers and they do love the water. They are very avid foragers. If you live in a good enough environment that could sustain them, they could easily forage for their entire diet during the day and you wouldn't have to spend that much money on food for them. However, obviously layer pellets are a good supplement, especially if you want hens that are gonna lay eggs. They are one of the most crossbred domestic breeds. So they come in so many different colors, and that is due to the fact that they are crossed with so many breeds. So you'll have traditional runners here like Charlotte. Charlotte's a fawn and white runner, so she's not actually mixed with any other domestic duck breed that I know of. But there are runners that look there are runners that look like Pekings. There's runners that look like Mallards/Rowans. There's ones that look like Silver Appleyards. There's ones that look like Buffs. I have one, a white one with a dark, like bluish black bill, and I could never figure out what exactly kind of runner she is, because she doesn't look like other white runners I've seen. So I'm not sure what exactly she is, but I'm guessing that she was a cross between some other type of breed. So there's a lot of variety with them. And you could probably selectively breed them at home if you wanted to create some colorful ones on your own. I also forgot to mention there's also ones that look like Cayugas. So there are black runners, but there's also ones that look more like Cayugas, so they will have that greenish iridescent glow to them, which is really pretty. They are hardy and they are not prone to illness. However, they do have one common health issue, and that is worms. So make sure that you are constantly on the lookout for worms in these guys and that you treat with dewormer immediately if you see that. And these ducks were used to create Buff Orpington and Khaki Campbell ducks. So although pretty much all domestic ducks are descended from mallards, these guys were actually instrumental in creating the Buff Orpington and Khaki Campbell duck. Right, so that's my video on the Indian runner duck. I hope this video was helpful to you guys. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.